Morning everyone, welcome to this week's virtual assembly on May the 4th. For us Star Wars fans out there, this is a very important day. Today I'm going to talk to you about routines and how this can be important on a day-to-day basis, especially during this period of time. There's also going to be a couple of opportunities today. A challenge set up by myself, and also an opportunity around a competition set by the Maths Department, so please listen out for this. Before we start though, like last week, Mr. Essex mentioned about the celebrations of birthdays. Likewise, this week we're all going to celebrate the birthdays that are happening. Please look out for your name if it is your birthday this week. Today I'd like to talk to you about routines, which will then be supported by organisation a little bit. We've now been working with the new timetables for just over a week. Hopefully you will find these certainly more manageable, but also the work more accessible through Google Classroom. If you can please talk to your teachers, obviously if there are any issues, and certainly liaise with your tutors, just letting them make sure that they know that you're okay and that you're getting on with work alright. And please do remember to keep posting your work up onto Google Classroom. So I'd like to talk to you about routines I've mentioned. Why do we have them? Well, actually, there's many benefits in regards to having routines. Our routines at school sadly disappeared due to, obviously, the current situation with us being forced to be at home. But we can create our own routines. Routines help us in regards to on a daily basis to create and organise our time. They help you feel more in control. Okay, with that control, it helps us be able to cope with the different changes which have been forced upon us. Okay, which then hopefully leads to maybe a better work-life balance. And that is really, really key. You've got to manage the amount of work you're doing with school, but also have a bit of freedom and obviously choice in regards to what you're doing. And we're trying to give you that choice, but you've got to balance that off and be sensible around that. If we can hopefully manage these and create these routines, which will then help to try and manage the amount of stress that we have in our lives. Okay, some of you may be struggling a little bit more than others, and that's not a problem. We've got to try and manage these routines and also the problem and also being at home just to try and hopefully reduce these stress levels. And don't think too big. These small targets of actually just trying to maybe try and do a little bit of work, then having a bit of downtime, talking to your friends, okay, a bit of gaming, etc., etc. Okay, these small targets will then give us small wins. It's about being sensible around that, okay? On my personal daily routine, I've got two kids at home, which I have to do homeschooling myself. So, quite simple, I put in our own daily routine. We try to stay within this just for my kids. It makes their life a little bit structured. They know where they are. I know where I am, more importantly. And we just work through the day, okay? It does change a little bit from day to day. That's not a problem. We have this rough idea that they know they need to have breakfast and be dressed by 9 o'clock. We're going to start schoolwork roughly about 10. And if we have different chunks of time where we try and give their own time, where they choose what they do, but then some independent time as well around reading and online games, which they control, okay? But it's about being sensible around that. And also, more importantly, at the end of the day, we then do some exercise, okay? Be it a bike ride, a walk, some game outside, depending on the weather. Been wet today, so I can obviously do that. But it's being sensible around that. Now, interestingly, our ex-student, Lewis Richardson, who's involved with Team GB for boxing, has also been quarantined at home. And it was in the newspaper more recently about his quarantine routine. Okay, he was due to go to the Olympics this year, but it's been cancelled till 2021. So therefore, he's had to change his current structures around what he has to do. He's got to manage that to make his training more effective. Now, Lewis has moved back to culture stuff from when he was up in Sheffield, but he's had to change his routine to suit his needs in order to be obviously sensible, but to manage his stress levels. And as you can see, he's got his own little routine, which is very clear and concise and structured. Okay, but as Lewis also says, he talks about the concept of, okay, small targets gives us small wins. He focuses on the small things, things that can be realistic and achievable in order to help manage the stress levels. So I like you to think about your daily routine, okay? Have a sensible time in regards to when you're going to get up, but make sure you're up, you've had breakfast, okay? Have a think about time when you need to start the tutor activity or some daily exercise. Okay, remember, exercise obviously is a very beneficial thing for us. But then break the day up into realistic chunks, okay? Either an hour or half an hour, okay? Whatever you want to do, but try and maintain that just to help have that level of control. Hopefully help reduce stress and obviously build up that daily habit of routine from day to day. It will make the day more structured and hopefully will help us cope with these different changes. But once again, developing that whole work-life balance. So I've already given you quite a lot of information around our routines. So I've now got a couple of videos for you from staff who would like to say hello.
Everyone, it's Mrs. Brown here, hoping that you're all staying safe, looking after yourselves and finding plenty of things to do at home. I've been spending lots of time with my dog Leo, as you can see, and reading lots and lots of books in my spare time as well. Don't forget to send your teachers all the brilliant things you're doing for English at home. We'd love to put more on the website. Also, tell your teachers what you've been reading. If you've been reading anything interesting at home, we'd love to hear from you a little bit more. Look after yourself, guys. I really hope you're keeping safe during this time and enjoying yourself as well.
Good morning, everybody. Mr. Julie here. Hopefully this video finds you safe and well. And just a quick note to say how important exercise is at this time. We've been in lockdown for about 6 weeks now, and it's really important for our physical and mental health and well-being that we are doing some exercise regularly, daily if we can. Something like Joe Wicks at 9 a.m. each morning, I know quite a lot of you have been trying to do those exercises, and there's a lot out there. And obviously now with PE, we've posted for year 7 and 8, some videos from Miss Everston. It's really important that you're trying to do something every day. So stay home, stay safe, and be as healthy as you can. Take care.
Hi, my name's Mrs. Brown and I'm the head of maths. I'm here just to talk about a couple of things. One is to say thank you for all the hard work you've been putting into your maths work. It's been really lovely to see how much effort everyone's been putting in and some of the great work. There are some examples of the great work put on the school gallery on the TLA website, so it's worth having a look and seeing if some of your work has made it onto there. The other thing I wanted to talk about was to introduce a competition that we're going to run, and it's all about people taking pictures of maths that they see either around the home or when they're out on their daily walks. I take my dogs out for a walk every day, and I started to notice things that I hadn't seen before, like numbers appearing in different places, patterns, shapes, tessellations, loads of different things that appear over the time I've been walking the dogs. So what I wanted to do is run a competition to see where you see maths when you're out and about, or whether you see maths around the home. I'm going to add a couple of examples now of the sort of things I've seen when I've been out walking. You can submit any type of picture. All you need to do is to send it to lisa.brown@tla.school using your school email address to send it to me. We're going to look at them, and we're going to do a winner and two runners up. The winner will win £15 of Amazon vouchers, and the two runners up will get £10 Amazon vouchers each. So Next time you're out and about on your walk, have a look and see what numbers and maths you can see.
So last week, Mr. Essex had a maths challenge for you. I've got a different sort of challenge based on an old TV brand called Catchphrase. Very simply, the phrase was say what you see. So you'll see seven images which represent seven movies. The first one, just an example, is that of a lion with a crown on its head. Okay, so you look at the image and you think, well, what can it be? What film can it be? Well, this film is The Lion King. So look at the seven images and then email me at my email address on the page now. Okay, so the first one is this image, 2 feet laughing. Okay, number two. And number three. Okay, number four. Remember, say what you can see. Keep it simple, focus on the key points. Okay, number five, slightly more trickier this one. Number six, one of my all-time favourite films myself. And number seven. So remember, think about the seven images. You can obviously go back through the assembly and email me at the address on the screen with the seven answers. Okay, I wish you all the best.
To finish this interview, I'd just like to think about those key points linked to the routines and how they can help on a day-to-day basis. Remember setting those small goals that can lead to those small wins, which is really important at this point in time. Try and have a go at Mrs. Brown's maths competition when you're out on your daily exercise. I look forward to seeing those emails linked to my challenge that I set you. I hope you have a great week. Keep following those timetables. Remember to post your work in Google Classrooms. Have a great time. Stay safe. Happy Star Wars Day, folks.